Given f of x, we want to find the inverse of our function, or f inverse of x, and f inverse of 8. To find the inverse of a function, we want to write the function in terms of x and y, interchange the x and y variables, and then solve for y. To understand why this works, we need to understand that the inverse function undoes the operation of f of x. So for example, if x is the input into our function f, and y is the output, these outputs become the inputs into the inverse function, which return the original value of x. So we can see these two functions undo each other. So to get started, we're first going to write the original function in terms of x and y. F of x equals y, so we would have y equals the quantity x minus 1 divided by the quantity x minus 3, which means our inverse function would be x equals the quantity y minus 1 divided by the quantity y minus 3. Notice how the output of y for f is the input x for the inverse function, and the input of x for f is the output of y for the inverse function. And now we're left to solve this for y and then replace y with inverse function notation. Since the right side is in fraction form, we could put this over 1 and then cross multiply. X times y minus 3 must equal 1 times y minus 1, or we could just multiply both sides by the quantity y minus 3. Either way, we would have x times the quantity y minus 3 equals y minus 1. Let's go ahead and distribute here. We have xy minus 3x equals y minus 1. Our goal is to solve this for y, and since there are two terms that contain a factor of y, we need those two terms on the left and all the other terms on the right. Let's start by subtracting y on both sides. That would give us xy minus 3x equals negative 1. Now let's go ahead and add 3x to both sides. That would be xy minus y equals 3x minus 1. And now to solve this for y, we'll have to factor out the common factor of y, leaving us with a factor of x minus 1. And now we'll divide both sides by the quantity x minus 1. So we have y equals quantity 3x minus 1 divided by the quantity x minus 1. This is our inverse function, so we'll replace y with f inverse of x. So we have f inverse of x equals the quantity 3x minus 1 divided by the quantity x minus 1. And now that we have the inverse function, we can determine f inverse of 8. F inverse of 8 is going to be equal to 3 times 8 minus 1 all over 8 minus 1. 24 minus 1 is 23, and 8 minus 1 is equal to 7. So f inverse of 8 is equal to 23/7. I hope you found this helpful.